Happy Monday to all. The Monday after the Super Bowl, the saddest day of the year, because for most of us, we're all football-starved, crazy people, and that's the end of football. Pro Bowl used to be the last game of the year, but they changed that and kind of sort of got rid of it, but not really. Real quick thoughts on the game last night. Congratulations to Orlando Brown, Creed Humphrey winning their first Super Bowl rings, and Blake Bell and James Winchester for winning ring number two. Oh, how awesome is that? Lane Johnson for the Eagles already has a ring from a couple years back, but Jalen Hurts does not. So, look, here's my thoughts on it. I'm not sad the Eagles lost because I'm a Cowboys fan. But my team is more pathetic right now, even though they were in the playoffs, and that's neither. We'll just let that go. The point of the matter is that I think most of America, regardless of who you're rooting for, unless you're just a diehard Chiefs fan, then I totally understand. But I think most of us wanted to see the Eagles, and Jalen Hurts specifically, get that shot. You know, it's one thing, the game ended on a flag, and the Chiefs were able just to drain the clock and kick a chip shot field goal. It was a great game. It was tied at 35. It was an exciting football game. There was momentum back and forth. I think we, as football fans, Americans, we all want to see the moment in big sporting events. We want to see bottom of the ninth, two outs, full count, down a few runs. Can you knock one out of the park to win it? The equivalent to that for the Super Bowl, you got less than 2 minutes. You're down 3 points or 4 points. Can you march down the field and get the winning score? And I think that was the one thing we were hoping to see, that or overtime. So the fact that the game kind of ended kind of like, flag, first down, they're just going to milk the clock, kick a field goal with a few seconds left, and that's all she wrote. It's a little disappointing. It's like seeing a really, really, really good movie or TV show and having a terrible ending, like Game of Thrones. But anyway, on to the topic at hand. We're going to talk about the SEC. The news broke late last week. As I was recording my video, we were still getting information. Like, I literally, as soon as I finished the video, you put out the social media stuff and everything. But what was funny, what we found out later, the whole Fox holdup, outside of like money and inventory, but the main thing they were more concerned about was a Michigan-Texas game. And you know, it's funny to me because no one loves Michigan and Texas more than Fox, especially their head coaches. And they wanted to make sure, so they basically, Texas and Michigan have a home and home coming up. And they just flipped the home away setup. It was going to be at Texas at first, the first game, but then they gave it to Michigan and they put Texas later. So Fox desperately didn't want to lose their precious Michigan-Texas game because, Lord, you watch that network and the coverage. They love them, some Texas and Michigan, especially Harbaugh. And we'll just move on. So anyway, SEC, it's happening. So what is that? What are the next steps? Well, the one thing everyone is going to want to know down the road, and right now SEC's had their winter meetings and they'll have their spring meetings, but the summer meetings, I'm sure SEC media days in July are going to be interesting, because the one thing everyone's going to want to know for the 2024 season is how the schedule's going to set up, how the conference is going to look. And while there may not be in a great hurry to figure that out, I think they would like to figure that out sometime in the summer, early part of the fall, usually when the schedule drops. But I think the one thing they're trying to figure out right now, who are going to be the permanent opponents. So while it's not officially announced yet, it's more than likely going to be a 3-6 or a 6-3 format, or however you want to phrase it. It is not to be confused with pods. Pods were thrown out there as an idea. You would put four teams in a pod. You would always play those three teams in a pod. Everyone would play each other, and then you have a rotation. The permanent opponents thing is slightly different. Just because you play everyone, play a certain three teams every year, doesn't mean those teams are going to play you every year. You see what I'm saying? It's a little confusing at times, but for example, like, I think for Texas, the most obvious trio for them to play every year for their permanent opponents would be OU, obviously. You reunite with the Aggies, and like, someone's got to win, someone's got to lose game that's entertaining and painful to watch at the same time. And then if you're a big fan of 60-70 Southwest Conference football, you put them back with Arkansas. Plus, you know, I think Texas wouldn't mind have a little rematch after what happened to them in Fayetteville just a couple years ago. So anyway, for OU, obviously, Texas will be one of their permanent opponents. And I know there's a lot of teams that are thrown out there. But, you know, three permanent opponents, and then you would play six other SEC teams that would rotate. So the way with the non-conference schedule, you would play everybody within a two-year span. So 1 year you play six opponents, the other would play another six. And so, therefore, you're not, like, waiting around for 8 or 9 years to have a home game against Georgia or a road game. Like Alabama and Georgia just never played each other unless it was in the SEC championship game. It was kind of ridiculous. It was stupid to have 8 games then, and it's silly to have 9. It's stupid to not have 9 games now. One thing that I've heard sprinkled around as kind of a problem, I'm hearing that there's might be some complaints about, we can't go to 9 conference games right away in 2024. Why not? Well, we have all these non-conference games that were promised. Oh, you mean like the cupcake garbage FCS teams that y'all like to play in November? Yeah. Y'all could just write a check and tell them to go F off as far as I'm concerned, but if that happens, we can't not schedule. All these games are scheduled out years in advance. And while that is true, those games also get canceled and rescheduled years in advance as well, or sometimes on short notice. So Georgia and Oklahoma was scheduled years in advance, but since we're joining the league, SEC gave marching orders to cancel that because we're going to play Georgia at some point anyway. But for Oklahoma, getting back to their three permanent rivals, Texas, some people throw in Missouri or Arkansas. I would love to play A&M on the reg. Kind of have a little Big 12 kind of green. I would like for Arkansas, A&M, and you know Texas to be ours. But I don't know how the math is going to work with all that. So The Athletic put out an article last week of how it might look. And this is not anything official. They just kind of gave their idea. So for Texas, they said A&M, OU, and Arkansas could probably be their opponents. For OU, they said Texas, Missouri, LSU. Could be interesting watch there. Like the Aggies, Texas, LSU, Mississippi State. Interesting there. Considering the fact that they have a rivalry game with Arkansas at Jerry World. Again, what I'm reading off is not official. This is just a pitch from the Athletic or an idea of what it could look like. Alabama's three permanent opponents, if they put Auburn, Tennessee, and Mississippi State. Interesting choice there. For Florida, they had Georgia, Auburn, and South Carolina. I get Georgia. I even get South Carolina. Auburn's interesting. It's almost like they're trying to rekindle that old 90s kind of semi-rivalry they had there. And for Tennessee not playing Florida every year, that would be different. So it'll be interesting to see how they work that out and figure it out at the end of the day. So, but yeah, that's something to pop up later down the line. Who would you like Oklahoma's permanent rivals to be? Now, Texas has got to be in there. You can't say we're not playing Texas. So Texas is one of them. So if you have two other choices, any reason given, put them down in the comments. Like, subscribe, comment. All those fun things YouTubers say. Let me know what you think. Hopefully we'll have a stream coming up soon with Eric Lopez. Talk about some softball. Talk about the SEC official announcement. And who knows what's up. Don't know when that's going to happen yet, but put out the word and see if we can set something up sometime this week. So until then, I am done rambling. Figure I'd check in and see how everyone's doing with the first day without football. The longest wait without football. But until next time, catch y'all later. Boomer.